So students, in this video we are going to discuss about gene therapy. So gene therapy is when DNA is introduced into a patient to treat a genetic disease. So there are many genetic disorders which will occur in the human being, right? So in order to cure the genetic disorders, there is a special process of treatment called as gene therapy. And this gene therapy process will be done in every hospital, okay? So this is what the gene therapy is. And here, basically how the genetic diseases will occur in a human being. Once there is a gene, specific gene, which is a faulty gene, which is present in that human being, then that genetic disease will occur in that human being. Then by the process of this gene therapy, how you can cure that genetic disease? By removing that faulty gene from that human being, from that patient, and inserting new gene, which is synthesized or functioning gene, into that patient. This will cure the genetic diseases. Let's see the process how it will done so that you can clearly understand. So let us take a patient. In that patient, there is a presence of faulty gene. Hence, he is suffering with a particular genetic disorder. Now we are going to select that patient, and then you are going to isolate the DNA, the particular faulty gene which is present in the chromosome. You are going to isolate this gene. Okay. Now, once the gene is isolated, then you are going to identify this faulty gene. And once it is identified, then you are going to remove this faulty gene from this, and then you are going to attach functioning gene to this whole DNA, and that process is called as gene therapy. So once you are going to once you are going to remove this gene and you are going to replace with functioning gene, then the process will be done in such a way that he will not be suffered with this genetic disorder anymore in his life, because he is completely cured by the process of gene therapy, right? So you are going to remove this faulty gene, and then you are going to insert the functioning gene in the place of that nucleotide, right? So this process is called as gene therapy. Now you have understood about this gene therapy, right? So this gene therapy process was initially started by a scientist called as Martin Klein in the year of 1980. So between the year of 1989 to 2018, there are 2900 clinical trials which has been done on this gene therapy, right? And then later two companies called as Spark Therapeutics and Novartis are approved by FDA, right? They are approved by FDA in the year of 2017. So these both are the companies where they perform this gene therapy process, okay? And hence they are approved by FDA. So as they are approved by the FDA, so there is no doubt the process of this gene therapy will be done good in these both organizations, okay? So not only this, in the same year of 2017, there are two drugs which are introduced and which are authorized and approved by FDA itself in order to cure this genetic disorders, and will be useful for this process of gene therapy. So what are those two drugs? They are Novartis Zolgensma, and another drug is Enalymes Patisiran. So these are the both drugs which are approved by FDA in the year of 2017 itself. So the first approved gene therapy experiment was done in the year of 1990 on September 14 in United States on a patient called Ashanti De Silva. So she is a patient who is 4 years old, and she is suffering from ADS-KIT. So ADS-KIT is a genetic disorder which is abbreviated as adenosine deaminase severe combined immunodeficiency. So she is suffering with this genetic disorder. So in order to cure this genetic disorder, they performed this gene therapy process of experiment which is approved in the year of 1990 on a patient Ashanti De Silva, right, in United States. So the experiment has been succeeded, and she is cured with this genetic disorder. So now let us see clearly about this gene therapy. So till now what I have explained you is nothing but the introduction about this gene therapy, and now I am going to explain the type of gene therapies and approaches in gene therapy, okay? So listen properly. So now let us discuss about types of gene therapy. So there are two types of gene therapies. They are somatic cell gene therapy and germline gene therapy. So firstly, let us discuss about somatic cell gene therapy. So the therapeutic gene will be transferred into somatic cells. Hence, it is called as somatic cell gene therapy. So what do you mean by this therapeutic gene? So previously I have said you, right, the faulty gene will be replaced by the functioning gene, right? And that functioning gene is called as therapeutic gene. So that therapeutic gene will be transferred into somatic cells of the human being, I mean the patient. Hence, this process is called as somatic cell gene therapy. So the best examples of the somatic cells which we can say are bone marrow cells, blood cells, skin cells, etc. I mean the therapeutic gene or the functioning gene will be transferred into these cells. They will choose one particular cell and they will be transferred into these cells. Right? And one more important thing which people have to remember regarding this somatic cell gene therapy is it will not be inherited into later generations. So now this patient will be cured by this process of gene therapy, but there is no guarantee that this disease will be passed to the future generations. It may be passed or it may not be passed. I mean, this is just a temporary purpose where only the patient can be cured by this disease. There is no guarantee that the disease can be passed to the future generations. I mean, to his offsprings or children. Right? So it will not be inherited into later generations. So now coming to the second one, which is germline gene therapy. Here the therapeutic gene in the sense which I have said you, right, which is also called as functioning gene, which will be where the faulty gene will be replaced by that functioning gene. So that is called as therapeutic gene, and it will be transferred into the germ cells. Hence this process is called as germline gene therapy. So what are the examples of these germ cells? Like, let's say eggs and sperms, right? So as we are transferring this gene directly into the eggs and sperms, so it is heritable. So that particular disease cannot be passed to the future generations. We can also save the future generation people also. I mean our offsprings and our children and their children, right? You can save your generations by the process of this germline gene therapy. Hence it is heritable, because we are going to transfer the gene directly into the eggs and sperms, right? So these are the types of gene therapies, and let us see what are the approaches in gene therapy. So there are two approaches in gene therapy. They are in vivo gene therapy and ex vivo gene therapy. So firstly, let us discuss about in vivo gene therapy. So coming to the first one, in vivo gene therapy. So the direct delivery of therapeutic gene into the target cell into the patient body is called as in vivo gene therapy. So what do you mean by this statement? So here patient body is nothing but the person who is infected with this genetic disorder. Who is suffering with this genetic disorder? Any type of genetic disorder is called as a patient. Okay, in our case. So the direct delivery of therapeutic gene is nothing but the functioning gene, right? And the direct delivery of this functioning gene into the patient body, there is no process involved. Just a direct delivery of this therapeutic gene into the patient body will be done, right? And that process, the direct delivery process, is called as in vivo gene therapy, right? So a particular target cell will be selected in that patient, and then that particular target cell will be selected, right? So to that target cell we are going to deliver the therapeutic gene, right? Directly. This is a direct process, hence it is called as in vivo gene therapy. And here in the process of this in vivo gene therapy, not only in this in vivo, even in the second type, which is ex vivo gene therapy, vectors will be used. Like, there are two types of vectors. There are viral vectors and non-viral vector systems. So in the process of this in vivo gene therapy, you can either use viral vectors or non-viral vectors. Okay, so what are these viral and non-viral vectors? I'm going to explain at the end of the video. Okay, so the best example of this in vivo gene therapy is cystic fibrosis. So what do you mean by the cystic fibrosis? So cystic fibrosis is a genetic disease which causes human beings. And I also explained about cystic fibrosis in detail in the diagrammatic form, and the link will be provided in the description box. So if you want to learn more about this cystic fibrosis, you can watch that video. Okay, so in this case of cystic fibrosis, there will be a lack of protein in that patient. Hence he is infected with the cystic fibrosis. So what is that protein, or else what is the gene? That gene is called as CFTR. It is abbreviated as cystic fibrosis transmembrane regulator. So there is absence of this CFTR gene in the patient. Hence he is suffering with a genetic disorder called as cystic fibrosis. Okay, so what is the what are the symptoms which you can see once the person is infected with the cystic fibrosis? So what will happen basically? There will be accumulation of sticky mucus in the respiratory tract and lungs of that human being, or as that patient who is suffering with this cystic fibrosis genetic disorder. Okay, So in order to cure this cystic fibrosis, we are going to insert this CFDR gene by using a vector called as adenovirus vector. So already I have said you right. So in the process of this in vivo gene therapy or ex vivo gene therapy, viral or non-viral vectors will be definitely used. If the vectors are not used, then the gene therapy process cannot be done. This is very important to remember. So in the case of cystic fibrosis, here we are going to use adenovirus vector. So how the process will be? See, I am going to clearly explain in the diagrammatic form. So listen properly. Okay. So now here what we are going to do is that we are going to select a particular bacterium which is carrying the plasmid with cloned normal human this CFTR gene. Okay, let us consider this green color one is nothing but the CFTR gene. Okay, fine. So now this CFTR gene, what you are going to do is that if you keep the CFTR gene, I mean this bacterium aside, you now you are going to select a genetically disabled retrovirus vector. Okay, you are going to select a retrovirus vector. So you know what, here in this case not retrovirus, here we have selected adenovirus previously itself, right? Adenovirus vector. So now we are going to take that vector, which is adenovirus vector, which is functioning gene, is inserted. So this is functioning gene, right? And that will be inserted into this vector. Okay, so remember, this is harmless virus vector. So as it doesn't contain any gene, right? This virus doesn't contain any gene, hence it is harmless. So as it doesn't contain any gene, so gene of our interest will be inserted into this harmless virus vector. So in our case, what is harmless virus vector? Adenovirus vector. Okay, so now this functioning gene with adenovirus vector will be inhaled by the patient. Either it may be given in the form of sprays or medicines, it will be inhaled by the patient. So once he inhale, what will happen? Then this particular unit will enter into the membrane of the lungs, right? It will enter into the membrane of the lungs. So what will happen in the lungs, in the layer of the lung? Now let us see clearly. So what will happen in the sense, so this is a unit in the sense, the functional gene which is present in the harmless virus vector, which is called as adenovirus vector. So this is a unit, and now this unit is combined with this lung cells. So why these lung cells? Because it has entered into the lung cells, right? The cell membrane of the lung contains lung cells, so it entered into the lung cells. So now what will happen? Now this gene which is present in the vector will enter into the nucleus of the lung cell. And one more important thing which you people have to remember is that it will not directly enter into the nucleus. Firstly, it will enter into the cell membrane of the lung cell, and once it entered into the cell membrane of the lung cell, then it will enter into the nucleus of that lung cell. Okay, so now what will happen once it entered into the nucleus of the lung cell? Now this lung cell with functional gene will undergo the process of mitosis. Now what will happen? Now it will undergo the process of division, it will get multiplied in number. Okay, so these are the cells now with normal gene function, which means it contains the gene of CFTR, cystic fibrosis transmembrane regulator, which I have already said you. So as that patient doesn't contain this CFTR gene, hence he is suffering with the cystic fibrosis disease. So now we have inserted CFTR gene artificially by the process of this gene therapy. Now there will be no more cystic fibrosis disease which you can see in that patient, because we have cured that patient with this in vivo gene therapy process, right? So this is what about in vivo gene therapy. Now I am going to explain about ex vivo gene therapy. So now let us discuss about ex vivo gene therapy. So previously at beginning itself I have said you right, there is a patient called as Ashanti De Silva who is 4 years old, and she is suffering with this ADS kit disease, adenosine deaminase severe combined immunodeficiency. And now we are going to take the example of this patient itself for our ex vivo gene therapy process. So remember that this is ADS kit, which is adenosine deaminase severe combined immunodeficiency. So now the disease will be the disease can be seen in that patient due to the lack of a gene called as, or due to the lack of an enzyme called as ADA. So what is this ADA? Adenosine deaminase. Okay, so when there is a lack of this enzyme, then that person will be infected or else will be suffered with that genetic disorder which is called as ADS kid. So now if that patient is suffering with that disease, then how we are going to cure? we are going to cure by the process of ex vivo gene therapy. Now I am going to explain the process of this ex vivo gene therapy diagrammatically. So listen properly. So now what you are going to do is that you are going to choose a particular bacteria which is carrying plasmid with cloned normal human ADA gene. So this green color one which I have drawn is nothing but the ADA gene. Okay, so this ADA gene is responsible in order to cure that genetic disorder. So if you keep this aside, and now you are going to choose a genetically disabled retrovirus vector. So previously what we have chosen in the case of this in vivo gene therapy, what we have chosen? We have chosen adenovirus vector. But now here what we are going to choose? We are going to choose retrovirus vector. Right, for different type of genetic disorders we are going to use different type of vectors. Okay, either it may be viral vector or non-viral vector. Okay, so now you have chosen the retrovirus vector, and now we have ADA gene with us, and now we are going to insert this ADA gene into this retrovirus vector. You are going to clone them. So cloned ADA gene is incorporated into virus. Okay, so this is harmless virus. Before itself I have said you, this is harmless virus because it doesn't contain any genetic material. So as I have shown you, that does this contains any genetic material? No, right? So we are inserting the pure artificial gene into this virus, but this doesn't own a genetic material, right? Hence now this is harmless. So now ADA gene has been inserted into the retrovirus vector over here. And now on the other hand, what you are going to do is that you are going to isolate T cells with the disabled ADA gene from the SCID patient. SCID patient in the sense, I mean the person who is infected with this ADA SCID disorder, I mean from that patient which I have said you, right? From that patient who is 4 years old, she is suffering from SCID. Now what you are going to do, you are going to isolate T cells from her. Once the T cells is isolated from her, then what you're going to do, you're going to introduce this incorporated virus vector onto this T cells. Now what will happen? Now that ADA gene will enter into the cell membrane, not directly into the nucleus, which I have said you, it will enter into the cell membrane of the T cells, right? And now once it entered into the cell membrane of these T cells, then later it will enter into the nucleus of the T cells, right? So once they are entered into the nucleus of these T cells, then they will be cultured. So how the culture process will be taken place, I have said you, right? So if you see my previous videos, I have explained you about cell culture process detailing, and the link will be provided in the description box. So once the culturing process will be done in such a way that you are going to take a petri dish, and in that petri dish you are going to place these two cells, or else any one of the cell will also be no worries over there, you can take two cells or any of the cell. Okay, so you are going to place that cell in the petri dish, and you are going to add the nutrients for that. So by absorbing the nutrients, these cells, we know it will get proliferated, which means it will get divided by the process of mitosis by using that nutrients which we have added. So once it utilizes that nutrients, then what will happen? Then it will get proliferated, and that will be implanted into the patient who is suffering with SCID disorder. So here the patient, in the sense, I have said you her name, right? Ashanti De Silva, who is suffering with ADA SCID, and now these, the proliferated cells, that cultured cells, will be implanted into her, who is 4 years old, right? And now once they are implanted, then she will not be suffered with this disease anymore, because we have cured the disease by the process of ex vivo gene therapy, right? So here the best example which we have chosen for our interest is SCID, which is severe combined immunodeficiency. So I already said you, right, for the process of this gene therapy, either it may be in vivo gene therapy or ex vivo gene therapy, viral vectors or non-viral vectors are definitely used. So the best examples of viral and non-viral vectors, I have researched a lot and I have got their names. Like in the case of viral vectors, retrovirus vector system, adenovirus vector system, adeno associated virus vector, herpes simple virus vector. In the case of non-viral vector system, we are going to use pure DNA construct, lipoplexes, DNA molecular conjugates, human artificial chromosome. And what are the tools and methods which are mainly used in order to perform these gene therapy techniques, either it may be ex vivo or in vivo? So what are the tools and what are the methods which are mainly used over here are gene gun, micro injection, using detergents and liposuction. So this gene gun and micro injection are considered as physical methods, whereas detergents and liposuction are considered as chemical methods. So by using these tools and methods, they will perform this gene therapy process in order to cure the patient who is suffering with genetic disorders. So this is what I want to explain to you about gene therapy. I hope you would like my explanation, and if you like it, just like the video, subscribe to my channel, and also press the bell icon for the latest updates. And if you have any doubts regarding this topic, you can comment in the comment section. Right? I'm going to clarify doubts immediately. Thank you.